In this morning's medical alert, uncovering the hidden sugars that are sabotaging your diet. And nutritionist Rebecca Scritchfield is here joining us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, so you're going to rock our world.
Exactly.
All right.
So it starts with sugar that we're trying to avoid, added sugar. Mm-hmm. We know it's in sodas and this and that, but it's also in a lot of other foods that health conscious people consume. And this is the amount of added sugar we get in a week.
Ugh, look at that.
It's 3.5 times what's considered safe, at least the weight gain, diabetes, heart disease. So we really need to cut back on that.
All right, so we're getting this through the foods that sometimes we think are healthy options but really aren't.
Yes.
So much.
Okay, and you really know how to read your label. So starting with yogurts and smoothies, mm-hmm. they'll say all natural, organic, and you'll grab it. Well, the smoothie is 2 days' worth of sugar. These yogurts are a full day, and it's added sugar.
And are these fat-free yogurts?
Yeah, they are fat-free, and so sometimes they'll add even more sugar, but it's sweetened. It's sweetened with added sugar. You can do better on your own with natural sugars from fruit. And actually, at breakfast, you still need protein and fat.
So you're going to show us how to make this ourselves.
Exactly. So this is peanut butter and blueberry
smoothie. I love that combination. I think that's so cool.
It's very interesting. Actually, tastes great. Uh-huh. Peanut butter is a great plant protein. Mm-hmm. It's got 8 grams of protein. That's more than any other nut. You also get fat, mono and poly, unsaturated. Those are the good fats. Mm-hmm. So that's why we're including that. And the blueberries, they are known as like little blue dynamos. You get 4 grams of fiber. You get lots of antioxidants. And those are anti-inflammatory. They help prevent diseases such
helps
as
your
cancer.
Skin.
Yes. So the vitamin C helps your skin and the collagen. So we love including those two ingredients. Add some milk, yogurt. You're good to go. Blend it up. And you're welcome to try that
I'm going to try this.
So
this is fat-free milk. You've got fat-free yogurt in here.
And the blueberries and the peanut butter. And it's got over 20 grams of protein in it.
Boy, just the little bit of peanut butter you used in that, you can really taste it.
Yep, it's got a nice taste.
And all right, I love it.
Double antioxidant combo there. So then lunches and dinners, you know, again, health conscious people, they know they need to eat their veggies. Problem is, to be honest, plain veggies do not taste good.
Nope, you got to add something to them.
So you reach for a sauce, like a sweet and sour sauce, or there are lots of other sauces that are literally almost 100% sugar, easily 1 to 2 days worth of sugar in a sauce. So what you're going to do is make your own. And you just get veggies from the store. I had frozen veggies. I added in some broccoli and some red pepper. And you need to saute those. So this is with Mazola corn oil.
Okay, just a little bit.
Yeah, just a little bit of corn oil. But what's good about this is a heart-healthy oil, and it's got some real interesting research around it. It has plant sterols. What this does is when you eat something healthy, it helps prevent the body from absorbing cholesterol.
Okay.
So it can help you with heart health.
So choose corn over vegetable oil to saute your vegetables.
Yes. So this has 4 times the plant sterols as olive oil and 40% more than canola oil. So, you know, a variety of oils are fine, but people don't know about corn oil.
So you're going to saute your vegetables, put them in your pan. You added some protein to that. You added some shrimp.
Yep, some shrimp, and you can get that already cooked in the store if you'd like. But to get the heat, so we're trying to mimic sweet and sour. For the heat, red pepper flakes.
Yep.
No sugar. It's great flavor.
And
then pineapple from the can.
That's lovely.
In its own juices. Yeah. No added sugar there. So you get the sweet and you get the sour.
Without all the
extra
sugar. And
you get very colorful and healthy. Exactly.
Awesome. Okay. When it comes to on the go, a lot of folks reach for bars.
Yes. They reach for bars, and they're marketed in a way. Antioxidants, fiber.
The buzzwords.
Or even these juices, like chia seed juices, it's still sugar. You know, backpacker bars are 1 to 2 days worth of sugar. These health halo type bars where people think, oh, I'll have one or two or three, it's
like
half
having
a day's
a cookie
worth
or a brownie.
I'd rather have that, right? It's something that at least you know what you're getting. You know, you're getting a kind of candy type food market as a health food. You really want to watch for that. You're much better off with the whole food type snacks. So again, with the blueberries, the peanuts, or something like veggies and hummus. We need, you know, lots of vegetables.
So hummus is the good dip to choose.
Right. Hummus, black bean dip too. Yep. You want something with some protein in it. But the point of it is reach for whole food type snacks, not, you know, something that is in those middle aisles that, you know, kind of looks like a healthier junk food.
All right. I know what I'm making for lunch, and that looks like a great dinner. Thanks,
good,
Rebecca.
You're welcome.
Appreciate it.
All
the time right now is